atmosphere here at the G-Mex. I can't see too many spare seats. I've got 7,000 people here tonight. As we get our first glimpse of John Jarvis. He hasn't been too active in recent years. But earned this title shot by virtue of a points win over Schoenebeugel Malinga. Remember, that was Eubank's last victim. Well, Jarvis beat him on the 5th of August, 1990. That was for the IBF Intercontinental title. Split decision that night. As I say, lost to Darren Van Horn, August last year, for the IBF super middle title, and that was his last ring appearance. And in just a moment, you will hear the familiar sounds of Tina Turner thumping out simply the best, the Eubank anthem. Everybody, but everybody on their feet. And the crowd, which is good to hear, are seemingly solidly behind Chris Eubank tonight. There will be the usual grand Eubank entrance, I'm sure. Incidentally, while we're waiting for Chris, let me very quickly congratulate Tony Halligan from Enfield and John Halton from Tyne and Wear, our competition winners. They are ringside tonight. We've got another competition too. Two pairs of tickets to Nigel Benn against Schoenebeugel Malinga. That's coming up at the Birmingham Indoor Arena on May 23. Details on page 580, 580 of Sport Text, or ring 0898 555 556. 0898 555 556. We're giving away two of the best seats in the house to Benn against Malinga at the NIA in Birmingham, May 23. And if you win, you can be there, like Tony Halligan and John Halton, who won our Chris Eubank competition. That number again, 0898 555556. Now then, so much for Birmingham. On the 23rd of May, right now, we are concerned with the action at the G-Mex in Manchester on Saturday, the 25th of April. This is G-Mex. Like the beginning of 2001, this. And that old familiar song means it's champion time. There is something about a world title fight that has the hairs on the nape of your neck standing up, especially when this man is involved, Chris Eubank. The honor guard of girls from the newspaper sponsoring tonight's fight. And here he comes, Ronnie Davis, his trainer, carrying the WBO championship belt. Barry Hearn, his manager, leading him in. Perfect record. 30 fights, 30 wins, 17 by the short route. And at this time, a good moment to welcome all our friends watching this on the Prime Network. On the other side of the Atlantic, we wish your compatriot John Jarvis from Virginia all success as we do Chris Eubank, the British champion of the world. And let's see if he pulls over the top rope. He usually does. Once they booed him, now they love him. Here we go. Up on the rope. As Ronnie Davis parades the belt, is Alan Hughes.
Ladies and gentlemen, promoted by Metrin in association with Jack Cricket and sponsored by the Daily Mirror and the Sunday Mirror, we are proud to present the main attraction of the evening, a super middleweight contest at 12 stone over 12 rounds, each of 3 minutes duration for the WBO Super Middleweight Championship of the World. Your judges for the contest are Thomas Vasquez of Puerto Rico, Arthur Ellison of Germany, Luke Jensen of Denmark. Your WBO supervisor is Ed
Referee
Levine
Stan Cristobal of South Africa, the judges, Tomas Vasquez Rivera from Puerto Rico, Knut Jensen from Denmark, and Arthur Ellison from Germany. The judges will score.
Of South Africa. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting and introducing to you in the red corner and the back short from Richmond in Virginia, the IBF Intercontinental Champion and challenger for the title, John Jarvis! And in the front of the blue corner of the gold shorts, I'm defeating his third contestant from Brighton, the reigning
He certainly did. It's an amazing reception, and he must be very heartened by that. He's had a lot of personal trouble and tragedies, and I'm sure that that atmosphere really got him going. What a fabulous atmosphere.
Wonderful atmosphere. John Jarvis had a little bit of trouble making the weight this morning, had to do a little bit of skipping. He is bang on the 12 stone weight limit. That is 168 pounds. This is 12 rounds of boxing for the WBO version of the World Super Middleweight Champion. The title holder, Chris Eubank, from Brighton on the southwest of England, in yellow. From Richmond in Virginia, John Jarvis is in black.
Yeah, Chris will want to do a good job on Jarvis tonight. He wants to look good. This guy will pose some problems for a short time, but I don't think for long. Eubank is in a mean mood. I'm told by Ronnie that he's in superb physical and mental condition, and he'll want to win inside here.
Well, I think, in fairness to Chris, the last fight against Sugarboy Malinga, which was a poor performance, I think that was exercising the memories of that tragic night at White Hart Lane. But tonight, a new chapter, and those thoughts must be put behind him.
He looked he looks just a steel fighter. He looked tired. He looked to be not right psychologically, and there's every reason why he shouldn't have been. But I think we're seeing a meaner fighter tonight here. Certainly more aggressive, and he started more aggressively than normal. Jarvis is just circling around the ring, trying to feel Eubank's out. Eubank is stalking him slowly. He's not close enough to him yet to land something decent. He's trying to shot him too far out. As the rounds progress, he'll actually slither forward and close the distance down between him and Jarvis. See the way that right hand fell a bit short. He's got to get a bit closer with him. Thank you. nice straight left jab from Jarvis, but pretty straight up. Look at how straight he is. Everything's very, very much in the traditional English style of boxing.
Good one from Eubank. He's clipped him on the jaw.
Can afford to let this guy throw punches at him and just counter him with a right or a left hook. There's a good left hook. He's shaking Jarvis right to his boots with that beautiful shot. Trying to lift his head up with that jab. He's got to learn how to creep up on top of his opponent. It's hard to teach an old dog new tricks, and as far as experience is concerned, Eubanks is certainly around for a time, so it's going to be difficult to teach him how to creep up on his opponent, but that's what he's got to do to get closer, especially when he's fighting a mover. Close down the gap and let them shots go.
Well, Chris scoring the use of a stool. Ronnie Davis, Freddie King in the corner. Eubanks posing to the crowd. And now condescends to sit down.
I love the way Ronnie just sat there waiting for him. He's an incredible man. Long right hand missed, a big sweeping right hand over the top. Nudged him with his elbow to get him away, and then he tried a left. He hit him with a good clipping left hook. That was the jab after that right hand, but he shook him with a nice little solid left hook near the end of the round.
Well, John Jarvis has only seen Eubank on television, and that really teaches you nothing, because the man, as we know, is so unpredictable. He can fight a completely different style of fight from one contest to the next. And you can watch his fights on television till you're square-eyed, and you really won't have too good an idea how to fight the man. As 30 opponents have found at their cost. Round two. Stan Christodoulou, who has refereed world title fights at every single weight there is to referee world title fights at. The only man ever to have done that.
Yeah, he refereed my world title fight against Pedroza. And fond memories of that night.
We Eubanks, all have.
Eubanks is starting to get closer now. Starting to get more dangerous. Keeping in range. Jarvis is very straight up. No lateral movement at all. Straight as a day.
Now, I've got to say, even on the evidence of a round and a half, this is a crisper Eubank than we saw against Sugarboy Malinga.
Yeah. Good right hand. And he's certainly more vicious. That Chuck Jarvis there. Good right hand. He's picking his shots better. He's getting closer. He's stalking them better. That's what he's got to do. Get up close on his opponents. And make that 2 or 3 inches of a difference just by stepping up on top of him and reaching with his punches.
Jarvis yet to find the range. The jab's falling short.
Yeah, Jarvis is doing the right thing. He's moving around. He's got to throw more punches, but he's got to keep Eubanks up. He's got to flick that jab more and throw more right hand. Good right hand to the body. I like the way Eubanks is picking the shots here. He really is stalking and staying on top of his opponent. That's good stuff. Doubling the jab up too, which is nice. Jarvis has got to put that right hand after the left jab. Eubanks' hand is down, so he's got to take a 1-2. Eubanks is really stalking now, doubling that jab up, getting close to him.
And what we must also remember is that Eubank has got a terrific chin. Nigel Benn and Mike Watson tested it to the full when he came through.
Yeah, he's got a marvellous chin, but, you know, if you keep getting hit on it the way he's been hit over the last few years, certainly has been damage done, but this guy's still a young man at 25, and the 12 stone limit, it's, you have to consider it fairly young, but he's been very active, did a lot of hard fights last few years. Good round again from Eubanks.
We will take a short break. Join us for more world title action at GMEX in just a moment. David Brenner, Barry McGuigan with you. Live from the ringside at GMEX in Manchester.
Good right hander, long left hook, just glanced off the top of Jarvis's head.
Third round, Eubank comes sulkily from his corner, glowers at John Jarvis.
Gotta stay on top of him. Some good shots. Not jabbing at all. Just going to get up, right up on top of him. Close the gap down. Jarvis is doing the right thing, just moving around, taking his time. I spoke to him earlier on in the week and he said he was going to try and outbox Eubank. He said about his task quite well. He's using his boxing ability, he's moving around the ring. No great variety in what he does, but it's been effective so far. It's kept Eubank at bay. You get the feeling that Eubank is just waiting. Oh, what about that? Oh, that is just right over. What a finish on. Oh, my God almighty, that was a super. He can count 100 over him. Oh, what a right hand.
That's it. All over. KO3. That was a piece of a shot. Right out of nothing. He saw the opening. Bang! Knockout. All over.
Yeah, that was beautiful right hand, right on the button. Watch this. Stalking him. I said he was just stalking him. Watch. Boom. Bang. There he goes. Good night, Vienna. That's it. What a right hand.
31 fights, 31 wins, 18 KOs, and still the WBO super middleweight champion of the world.
It's a sort of a win that he needed, Dave. It'll do his spirits a world of good. And, he's endeared the public once again. What a fabulous, beautiful right hand. Perfect shot.
Well, I'll tell you something, Barry. He was so confident of a win, was Chris, that he's already lined up his next title defense. That will be against Ron Essett, who was the number two choice opponent here tonight. Ron Essett, the NABF champion, will meet Chris Eubank in Portugal on June the 26th. We, of course, will be there. That was some
ladies
performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, in a 1 minute 50 seconds of round three, by a count out, the winner and still the WBO middleweight champion of the world, Chris Eubank.
Barry, I think we can say that back to the best tonight.
Yeah, that was perfect. He stalked him and he didn't waste anything. He just picked his shots very carefully. He was very cool, very relaxed. He knew what he was out there to do. And that right hand, it was one punch. And he stalked him, got him in the right position.